you know, experienced Zone 5 MVP, and Landry comes with a little bit of a reputation. You see that he can play with a chip on his shoulder, and I think therein we will find some matchup problems, and we'll see some bodies thrown at him.
You love to see what they can bring on the floor. And of course, you've got also the young man, Nijimbere, who came out firing, absolutely unconscious of the floor, starting the game with 4 of 4 from three-point range in their previous encounter. So you will definitely be interesting to see how he comes out for this encounter.
Well, there's going to be a chance now for us to have a look at the teams as they get ready for us. There are profiles, and we're going to start and have a look at that before we get into the competition.
Our idea is trying to compete and try to give the best of ourselves for trying to achieve the crosses. For this, we are in a very, very, very tough group. But our idea is competing all the days, and depending of the results, I think that the most important game is the first.
We've prepared quite efficiently. We're quite energetic about what is in front of us and what we want to do. We understand it's not going to be an easy road. The brand of basketball that we're playing is very exciting. It's good for the eye, you know. So every single time they come out here to come watch us, they'll walk away knowing for a fact that they got their money's worth. I mean, we're under no illusion as to what's going to happen. The guys going to come out swinging. There's no question about it. But we're ready for it.
From the Great Rift Valley at the junction between the African Great Lakes region and East Africa, hails Urinani Basketball Club, and where the Indian and Atlantic Oceans meet at the convergence of the Agulhas and Benguela currents, right up Table Mountain, hails the Cape Town Tigers. This is the road to Basketball Africa League 2023, and our final matchup in our quadruple header, it is the hosts Cape Town Tigers taking on Urinani. And it's been a quadruple header, so this is the last game. But this morning, an entertaining game all the way down to the last seconds of the game. Cospien going down by 2 to the Matero Magic, and then the KPA getting blown out by NBA Academy Africa. And then we've just seen a slugfest just before we tip off, a slugfest between Ferroviario Beira going down 72-88 to the City Oilers.
Coach, following yesterday's defeat, what was the main focus in practice?
Well, absolutely not playing like in the second half, no, yesterday, because I think that all the good work that we did in the first day and in the first half yesterday, we throw to the base in that 20 minutes. I think that we didn't play like a team. We play individual. We play only arriving in 2 against 2, and with if you play like this against this kind of teams like NBA Academy or Cape Town Tigers, with a very, very good physically and they are the best in transitions and in a fast game, you lose. Obviously, we have another weapons that yesterday in the second half we didn't do anything.
Yeah, and mentioning your opponents, Cape Town Tigers, they strive with those three-pointers. What is the defensive strategy for this game?
Well, collapsing, try that not having an open game, no run back, because at the moment that they don't run, okay, you can compete against them. At the moment that they run, I think that in these 8 teams, that are playing in Johannesburg, it's impossible competing against them. For this, try not allow to them to run, and after collapsing in defense and in offense, try to spread the court, playing against their helps, and trying to reverse in the ball, playing with spacing. This is the most general things that we have to do.
Thank you, Coach. All the best.
Okay, thank you.
Starting 5 for Urinani. Adonis Filer is going to lead the backcourt. They need him to stay on the floor today. Landry Ndikumana disappeared in the game against the Academy. And Ajehi Baru also disappearing yesterday's game. And then the backcourt rounded up by Gwibe Nijimbero and Michael Kazungu Zibwa as well. Also not playing up to his skills in yesterday's game against the NBA Academy. A player that can shoot the three ball and was also playing about 12 minutes in yesterday's game. Gwibe Nijimbere really stood out, especially in that first quarter, and didn't see him for much of the game. And we hope that today he's going to be back. And the first quarter is going to be a hot, fiery start. And we go over to Coach Flosh Ngwenya. Let's hear his thoughts.
Coach, you've qualified for the semis and you are unbeaten so far. How do you think you match up against Urunani?
Well, I mean, so I watched them play for the past 2 days. I think they're a very good team. They play hard. They move the ball very well. It's going to be a battle. I think they both want to, both of us want to go unbeaten to top the group. But look, it's going to be an interesting game.
And your team trailed behind in that first quarter yesterday against NBA Academy. What are you looking for from your team in that opening quarter?
Well, it was against Kenya Port Authority.
Kenya Port, yeah.
So look, we want to have a better start, obviously. But when I stay in this basketball, you don't get to win the game in the first quarter. You know, you get to win the game in the fourth quarter when the final whistle goes. So we have to make adjustments should we find ourselves in any slump of some sort. Just the adjustment thereof, how do we get out of it.
Deng has also been one of your playmakers for your team. Just an update on that injury.
Well, he picked up a bit of a strain, nothing serious, but we felt that we've already qualified for the semi-final, so there's no point in trying to risk him, so we're going to rest him today and get him ready for Saturday.
Thank you, Coach.
Thank you so much.
Well, let's have a look at the starting five of the Cape Town Tigers. It's the Kanapamo Selepe getting a start ahead of Dudeng. We heard him talk about the injury, Coach Flosh Ngwenya, Raphael Putney, and Peter Prinsloo, the captain, and the new
Town Tigers a very hard time on court. Well-deserved player of the match, accolade Adonis Feiler. What was said amongst you guys following that previous loss? Because you guys came out guns blazing today.
Yeah, we were a little disappointed in the way that we played against NBA Academy. But we just decided to come out, forget that game, and just, you know, move on to the next.
We saw some sportsmanship, Patney giving you a hug there. Would you care to share what was said amongst yourselves?
Oh, no, you know what? He's from America. He knows a couple of my friends from Chicago. So we just chopped it up about that. And he told me, you know, I was a good player and likewise about himself. And, yeah, that was basically it.
Was this a huge confidence booster ahead of the semis?
Yeah, it actually was. We needed this win after coming off a loss like that. But shout out to Cape Town Tigers. They gave us a run for our money. That last quarter was very hard. Shout out to them for, you know, sticking with the game and still fighting the whole time. But, yeah, this was a very big confidence booster for us.
Well, shout out to you for that sublime performance. Congratulations.
Thank you.
That is Adonis Feiler saying he's certainly pleased and happy with his team's performance. Joined now by the captain of Urunani, Landry Ndugumana. Your coach said it's hard to beat Cape Town Tigers at home, but it seems that wasn't an issue for you guys here today.
Today our issue was to go more aggressive, to share the ball. That was the target for the game today, yeah.
Yeah, your coach also spoke about that in the previous game there was no synergy and teamwork. Would you say that also contributed to this victory, the teamwork that we saw today on court?
Yeah, because the way we played yesterday was we didn't play well. So we go back, we organize ourselves, we talk about the game for yesterday. Then today we say let's come strong and more energy. Yeah.
Well, thank you so much and congratulations.
No, thank you.
That is Landry Ndugumana. He is certainly keeping it very calm because he knows that the job is far from over. And right now, joined by the Cape Town Tigers captain, Peter Prinsloo. You are breathing heavily, Peter. It looked like a very different team here today. What happened?
At the end of the game, a lot of frustration. But maybe we thought we were going to walk in and get an easy W. I don't know if guys weren't focused. Or